Hi everyone, I'm Sarah from EdTech. In this video today, we're going to be going over using the One by Wacom drawing tablet with PowerPoint to create more engaging lessons. If you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do so. We post all sorts of videos to help teachers use tech in their classroom. When you are teaching online, you no longer have the whiteboard or the smart board to write on in front of your students. Many teachers, when teaching online, are using devices that don't support touchscreen capabilities that make annotating so easy. But this drawing tablet can totally recreate your online teaching experience by giving you that ability to annotate quickly and easily. So this here is the One by Wacom drawing tablet. So as you guys can see, it's just a blank tablet surface, almost like a larger mouse pad. It also comes with a pen and a cord to hook it up to your computer via USB. So this whole tablet corresponds to your screen, but you're not able to see your screen on the tablet. So there is a little bit of a learning curve because you have to get used to writing on a tablet but looking at your screen. But don't be discouraged if it's a little bit of struggle at the beginning. It's super easy and it gets more comfortable as time goes on and you'll get the hang of it really quickly. This tablet also comes at a very decent price point. So I got this for about 60 bucks, which is a lot nicer than other ones on the market that can be in the hundreds of dollars. So those more expensive tablets are actually more artist focused than they are teacher focused. So you don't need to be dropping a whole bunch of money on a drawing tablet. This one right here will transform your classroom exceptionally. Plus, this tablet is super easy to transport. It's light, it's thin, and all you have to do to set it up is plug it in. So the first time you use it, you'll actually need to go to the Wacom website and download and install the driver, but that should take no more than 2 minutes. So like I said before, this whole screen area corresponds to what is on your screen. So if I'm writing up here at the top of my tablet, it will actually appear up here on the top of my slides. You can also use this tablet for mouse movements. So as you can see, I'm not pressing on the tablet, but you can still see where my movements are. So this tablet can be used in many different applications, but we're going to go over using it in PowerPoint today. So many teachers are using PowerPoint for their presentations, and adding in this tablet will really increase the value of those presentations because you guys can now annotate right on your slides. You guys can use the Wacom drawing tablet to add some annotations when you're preparing your slides, during your slideshow, or if you're just jumping on a quick call to explain a concept to a student. So if you want to add some annotations before you begin presenting, you can just go up to the Draw tab and choose your pen. Then you can begin writing right on your slide. So these annotations will appear when you begin your presentation. So when I'm presenting, I'm actually also using ClassPoint. So ClassPoint allows me to add a little bit of interactivity to my slides, along with making the annotating tools much more accessible than what PowerPoint offers. So before I begin my presentations, I can go up to the Ink No ClassPoint tab and set the correct number and the correct colors of my pens. So I can change these, and then when I go into my presentation, the pen colors that I've chosen are here at the bottom. So I can easily choose one and then begin writing right away. So if you're not using ClassPoint, to change the color, you have to hold down on the pen to open up the menu, go to pointer options, and then ink color. So this is a couple more steps than having all of your pens really accessible right on the toolbar. There are two buttons on this pen, and you can customize them to do whatever you would like back in those driver settings. So one of mine is set to an eraser, so I can quickly erase my mistakes. So another feature that I really like is that the tablet and the pen support different pressure sensitivities. So let's change my color. And the faster that I write, the thinner that the writing is going to be. And the slower that I write, the thicker my pen is going to be. So once I have run out of room on this slide, I can always go into the whiteboard icon and add in a blank whiteboard slide. So these can be customized when I am back in edit mode of PowerPoint. So I can go to my whiteboard backgrounds and I'm going to add in a SWOT analysis so that I can use it in my next class. So I can just click use an image and I have a picture here and give it a title. And then when I go into my presentation mode and I go to add a blank whiteboard slide, I have the SWOT analysis option and I can have a discussion with my students. And then I can just begin writing all of their ideas. Like I said before, you guys can customize these two different buttons on the side of your pen in that driver application on your desktop. So if we open that up, you guys can see that there are plenty of different options for you to choose from to have these buttons be whatever you would like. However, I do have to be honest with you that I do usually disable these buttons because they're just in the right spot where my thumb is always hitting them. So I'll always bring up an eraser when I don't really mean for it to. My next tip is actually also in these driver settings under the mapping section. So right now, my tablet maps my full screen, so every corner of the tablet corresponds to a corner on my screen. However, this means that I have to move my arm all over the place, so normally I do set it to only be a portion of my screen. So to do that, I can just go into a portion, and you can set the portion that you want it to be at. So usually I do this corner, and now when I'm on my tablet, I don't have to move my arm, and I can still get around to my whole entire screen. My third tip is to just be cautious when using this tablet with a dual monitor. So when you're using dual monitors, sometimes it won't always calibrate correctly. So if you are, just make sure that your screen area is set to the correct monitor. And my last tip is to use the Wacom tablet with the screen recording feature in PowerPoint. So back in PowerPoint, if you go to the Insert tab and go to Screen Recording, you can record your screen, annotate on your slides, add in some voice recording, and then send that to your students if you don't have a live online class to teach. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. I'll see you soon.